Thank you. Thank you. Did you just get back too?
Oh, hey there, instructor. Welcome back.
Well, the building's still standing, so I guess you all behaved yourselves.
Excellent.
It looks like you've really thrown yourself into helping out the student council, Reen. But you spend all your time working, and life will just pass you by before you know it.
Alas, if only my evil stepteacher would stop dumping a bunch of work on me and let me go to the ball.
Hey, did something happen? You look really beat.
Nothing bad. Just been real busy these last couple days.
That Toval really needs to learn how to treat a lady.
Honestly, dumping that much work on me? Come on, I'm too delicate for that.
I guess your hot date didn't turn out so well then?
Huh?
Of course it did! As if a night with me could fall short of unforgettable.
He was just amazing. Such a gentleman.
So strong. So passionate.
But I'm afraid all the details might be more than you could handle.
It's too soon to corrupt your poor, innocent heart.
Yeah. I almost want to believe it, but yeah, I don't think so.
Everything okay last night, then? Nothing major happened while I was away?
Not particularly. Oh, wait. Actually, we had a woman show up claiming to be the dorm's new caretaker. Did you know about this?
Oh, she's here already? I'd heard that the Reinford family was sending a maid, but I wasn't sure when she'd arrive.
Something sure smells good, though.
Oh, I'll bet that's Sharon fixing dinner. She's a great cook. She made breakfast for us today, too.
Oh, I can hardly wait. This Class 7 gig has some real fringe benefits. I'll have to get her to whip up some snacks to go with my beer later.
Looks like she knew about Elise's family after all.
Welcome back, Master Reen. Lady Sarah?
Oh, hey, Sharon. Good to see you. You can stop with the Master Reen stuff, though. It's not like I'm the one paying your salary.
Oh, but that just wouldn't do at all. Politeness toward those I serve is part of the maid's code of honor. Or might you prefer something more like, my dearest Reen?
Whoa! Not in front of the teacher.
It's a pleasure to meet you. My name is Sharon. I was sent here to serve you, courtesy of the Reinford family. I will do my utmost to cater to your every need. I hope I can be of service.
Oh, the pleasure's all mine. Though if you don't mind my saying, you look a little familiar. Are you sure we haven't met somewhere before?
Huh?
I'm afraid we haven't. You certainly don't seem to be an individual one would easily forget. I look forward to serving you, lady.
Why, thank you, Sharon Kruger.
This feels like a good time to make my exit. This looks like...
Please don't worry about me. While I still have much to learn before I feel like I deserve my status among the nobility, I've been blessed with wonderful friends, and I'm enjoying life here at the Academy. I often feel more concerned for how you're faring in your own studies. Thor's Military Academy is well known for its connections to Emperor Dreykul's and its strenuous curriculum. And I worry that the dangers you face in your training could catch even you by surprise someday. I pray you don't neglect your own well-being. The world has many soldiers, but you're my only brother. Elise Schwarzer.
You never change, do you, Elise? Oh, I guess it's probably me who hasn't changed much.
Thank you.
really should write back to her. And to Mom and Dad, for that matter.
Misty here, filling your speakers with wit and charm once again. I'm coming to you live from Radio Trista, and it's 9 p.m. on this calm June 20th evening. Let's kick off this week's Aubin Time. The weather around the capital has sure been wet lately, but not very wild. I thought that rain would never let up. Thanks to that, I ended up holed up in my room, even on my precious days off. Still, the end of June's just around the corner, which means summer festivals are in full swing across Erebonia. The festival out in the port city of Ordis is known for the breathtaking sight of hundreds of bonfires afloat on the bay. In the old capital of St. Arc, they know how to party hard with a festival that keeps going for 5 nights straight. Unfortunately, I've never been able to get out to either of them. I'm hoping to make it up to myself by taking the train to some far-off destination on my next vacation. Now, where would be the perfect place for this wayward traveler to visit? I'd love to visit Crossbell. Exploring its theme park and seeing one of Arkenseal's theatrical performances would be great. But the thought of just riding to the end of the line and taking in the rustic beauty of the Nord Highlands is just so tempting. I know, Director, I know. Is it too much to ask to let a girl dream big?